back to another session. So in the we already started lesson 5, right? So hope you understood and liked it. Yes. So every lesson has a message also, right? We should understand it and we have to implement in our life. Hope you liked it. You know. So we discussed about different colors. What is the special purpose of that color? Yes. So today we are going to start the after lesson exercises. So please be ready with the textbook, children. Textbook, pencil, and eraser, and open page number 38. Okay. So we will start with the fill in the blanks. Yeah, bit fill in the blanks. Hope you are ready. So we are going to discuss fill in the blanks, question and answers, you know, and antonyms and everything. Don't write anything. First, try to understand the concept. Don't worry about the notes. Don't just copy. Just concentrate. I will send you the notes later. Okay? So whenever you are free, you can write them. So first, we'll go through fill in the blanks. First one, dash is the color of nature. What is the nature color will be? It is green in color. So the first answer will be green in color. Let's see the next one. Dash is the color of wisdom. So we can check in our lesson also. If you want, if you go turn your page back and go back and check for the answer. So violet. Dash color brings warmth. So which color brings warmth? So yellow color brings warmth. Dash is the color of love. So what is the color of love? It is red. So whenever you want to say that you have love to your mother or father, take them and give them rose. They will understand. Because it is a color of love. Fifth one, dash is the color of silence. Indigo. Indigo is the color of silence. Dash is the color of water. Blue. Blue is the color of water. So we all did this discussion in the previous session, right? So let's move on to the next topic. Yes, you are ready? Together it will be a if you join the hands and stretch the sky, it will shine. You see it? Which looks very beautiful and wonderful. Yes or no? So after the rain told about this, we stop fighting. Okay. So next week would be discuss. What do you think? The colors are ashamed. When the rain told them what is the importance of the colors, so they felt ashamed of themselves for fighting. So each one of them said, "Oh, I am the color of you. I am this. I give. It is fun. I give warmth. I give wisdom." Yes, every color fight for each other. No, so and. They stopped talking together. They were very sad, and after the rain came and spoke to these colors, they felt ashamed for their behavior. Next, we will move on to understanding words.
Fit.
So these are a few to opposites. So now we will move on to the next topic, understanding the rules. So we have certain rules in English we have to follow. Let's see few rules. Words like he, she, it are used in the place of nouns. So I hope you are familiar with the nouns. So what are nouns? Nouns are the names of people. So nouns are the names of people, places, things, animals. It comes under birds or flowers, fruits, all under comes nouns only. So he, she and it are used in the place of nouns. So there are some more words which used in the place of noun. For example, Sam and Bonnie are best friends. They like to play chess. So the word written in red, it is also a used instead of nouns. My cousins are coming to my home. We all will go to the park. So instead of taking the cousins' names, all the cousins' names, we all go together to the park. I am going to the market. Will you come with me? So you, we, that, this, they, those. So many words are there. So we use them in place of nouns instead of nouns. So let's see what else we have. All such words that are used in the place of nouns are called pronouns. What are pronouns words? All these words used in the place of nouns. We will remove the noun and we can use them. Okay? These are called pronouns. Okay, let's see. Anil is a good boy. Runs very fast. Anil always comes first in class. So I want to tell you about Anil. So all the time I will say Anil is a good boy. Anil runs very fast. Anil always comes first in the class. And Anil do this. Anil does that. So then you will ask me, teacher, why you are always saying Anil, 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 Anil? Why I have to use that Anil word all the time? So instead, I will do this. And see, he runs very fast. Instead of now, I can use this. Instead of mentioning Anil all the time, I can use he. He is used for boys. She is used for girls or women. Okay? So, instead in the place of nouns, we used pronouns. Okay? So, hope you are understood with the concept. We will see more examples also. Now, we will move on to the next page, page number 40. My friends. Friends is a plural form. It is not one friend. So many friends. It can be 2, 3, 4, any number. Yes? So friend is a singular. Friends is a plural. So my friends. So I have few friends. They went. Where they went? They want to watch a cricket match. So Dash will go to the stadium. So should I say more friends are there. So let's say for example 10 friends are there. So they want to watch a cricket match. So I should choose the answer I or they. I have to use they. So the first answer would be they. They will go to stadium. So my friends, they want to watch a cricket match. So they went to the stadium. I means we are talking about only one person here. They means more. Okay, so the correct answer would be they. Move on to the next example. Ravi likes to play guitar. Ravi, we are talking about one person here. Yes, so we are talking about Ravi only. Dash plays it very well. So should I use I or he? So instead of Anil, I use the word he. He plays it very well. So move on to the third example. My mother has brought fruits for me and for my brother. So my mother, she brought fruits for me and for my brother. Dash like to eat apples. So she brought some fruits for me and for my brother. So it or we should use. It is we should use we. We like to eat apples. It is usually used for the thing, not for the people. So we like to eat apples. So move on to the next example. Will Dash come for my birthday party? So how you will ask the friend, will you come to my birthday party? That is how you are asked, right? So will you come for my birthday party or will we come to my birthday party? I should say we calling, inviting for my birthday party? No. So you is the answer. So hums, dog is playing with a ball. So we are talking about dog here. She or it. So which answer, which option we choose? It. It is very naughty. So we are talking about dog here. So it is very naughty. We should. So as I said, when we talk about animals, we use the it. So it is very naughty. And next, we got a new concept, children. So I will do this in the next class. Okay. So hope you are clear with the pronouns, right? So pronouns are the words which we place them instead of nouns, right? I gave you one example regarding Anil. Hope you are this clear. If you don't understand it, please go through this video again. And your homework, today's homework will be, you read the lesson. See, whatever the questions, every time whatever the questions you see after the end of the lesson, you will be able to answer if you understand the lesson very well. Okay, hope the concepts are clear. In the next session, we will come up with the new concept. Thank you. Have a good day.